Hello everyone, welcome back to Anatomy at Easiest. Now in today's video, we will learn how to identify the major bones of lower limb, all the long bones of lower limb and the hip bone and patella. For the tarsals and metatarsals, we will study all that bones in another video. So let's start. These are the bones of lower limb. Now you can see that these bones are long as compared to the bones of upper limb. The bones present here are the femur, tibia, fibula, hip bone and the patella. So first of all, we will see how to identify the individual bones. Now this is femur. Femur is the longest bone of our body. It is around 45 centimeters in length. It is the longest bone, and to identify it, you can see towards the upper end this globular shaped structure is present, which is called as head of femur. It articulates with the hip bone to form hip joint, and this is called as head of femur. Continuation to the head, a constricted portion is present which connects the head to the rest of shaft, which is called as neck. So on the upper hand, the most identifying feature is this head and then the neck. Now you can see on the shaft is convex like this. Now this convexity is present anteriorly. So the shaft is convex anteriorly. On to the lower end, two condyles are present, which articulates with the condyles, reciprocal condyles of tibia. Now these condyles are continuous with each other anteriorly, and posteriorly they present a deep notch like structure. A deep groove or deep notch is present between the two condyles, and the condyles are overhanging posteriorly more as compared to the anterior side. So this clearly defines the superior end, the lower end. On the superior head or the upper head, head and neck is present, and on the lower end, two condyles are present. Anteriorly, the condyles are continuous, while posteriorly, they are separated by a notch. Also, the shaft is convex anteriorly. Now, head is articulating with hip bone, so direction of head is medially. It is directed slightly medially, upwards and forwards, like this. Now, to hold the hip femur in anatomical position, the main point of anatomical position is that these two condyles lie in the same horizontal plane. So, to keep this in anatomical position, one way is to keep the femur on table. When you keep the femur on table, then the direction of head is automatically medially forwards and upwards. Or another way is to hold the neck of femur in the index finger like this. If you hold like this, then the anatomical position of femur automatically comes. So these are the two ways to hold femur in anatomical position. And the side determination of femur, this is medially, this is anteriorly, this is superior, inferior. So this femur is of left side. You can see like this, this femur is of left side. In anatomical position, either hold like this or keep it on table. Now second bone is this one, which is hip bone. Now you can see, to identify the hip bone is superiorly and inferiorly expanded, and in the central portion it is constricted. Superiorly also it is expanded, inferiorly it is also expanded and constricted in the middle side. So this is the superior side, this is the inferior side. On the inferior side, a foramen is present, and on the superior side it is blade like. So inferior is clear. This foramen is called as obturator foramen. Now how to identify the medial and lateral aspect? Most of the medial surface is smooth. Because of the pelvic cavity, most of the surface is smooth. On the lateral side, this cup-shaped cavity is present, which is called as acetabulum. Acetabulum is the part where the head of femur articulates to form the hip joint. So this is present outwards or towards the lateral side. So this is lateral and this is medial. Now how to determine anterior and posterior? See the inferior side. Onto the inferior side, posteriorly, this rough tuberosity is present, which is called as ischial tuberosity. And here a spine is present, which is called as ischial spine. These are present posteriorly. Anteriorly, this is pubis, and here the two pubis articulates with each other to form the pubic symphysis. This is present anteriorly. Also, near to the upper end of pubis, a tubercle is present, which is called as pubic tubercle. So very clear, this side is medial, that is lateral, this is superior or upper end, this is lower end, pubis anteriorly and ischium, ischial tuberosity and spine posteriorly. So this is again the bone of left side. Now how to hold in an anatomical position? For holding the anatomical position, this largest notch of whole bone, this notch, which is called as greater sciatic notch, keep your thumb inside this and hold the bone like this. Keep the lateral side laterally and medial medially, thumb in that and fingers in the front, pubis anteriorly, ischium posteriorly and thumb backward. So this is the side determination or the correct way to hold the hip bone. This is the bone of left side. You have to hold in the same hand. If this was of right, I have to hold this one this way, and then the acetabulum will face medially. So this is of left side. I have to hold like this. Now the anatomical position of hip bone, very important. The anatomical position, for the anatomical position, you have to keep the pubic tubercle and this part anterior most point, which is called as anterior superior iliac spine. This is iliac crest, this curved structure, and the anterior most point is called as anterior superior iliac spine. We have to keep this point and this point in the same coronal plane. Same coronal plane means like this. Suppose my hand is a wall and I have to keep these two points straight onto this. So it is somewhat tilted, not like this, it is like this. These two points in same coronal plane, lateral laterally, medially, superior inferiorly, and these two points lie in the same coronal plane. So this is the anatomical position of hip bone. Very important, very frequently asked question in the vivas, how to hold or hold the hip bone in the correct position of our body. Now next bone is tibia, another long bone. This is tibia. Now how to identify tibia? On the upper end, two condyles are present which accommodate the two condyles of femur, and on the lower end this downward projection is present, which is called as malleolus. Now tibia, as it is the medial bone of lower limb, so this is called as medial malleolus. Now this is the upper end, this is the lower end. On the anterior side, near the upper end, a tuberosity is present, which is called as tibial tuberosity, and beneath that, most sharpest or most prominent border of tibia is present, which is called as anterior border. So this is the anterior side of tibia. Now upper end, lower end, anterior, posterior, the malleolus, as the malleolus is medial, so it is present on the medial side. The position of tibia, as this is the medial bone, so it is also of left side. Keep the malleolus onto the medial side, anterior anteriorly, and determine the side of tibia. This is the medial bone of left side. After that, we come to fibula, another long bone of lower limb. It is the thin bone, the lateral bone of leg, and its shaft is highly curved or Its shape is highly distorted because it is a very thin bone and many muscles are attached on it. So due to the pull of muscles, the shaft is variable in its shape. It is not circular or triangular. The shaft shape is changing everywhere. Now, to determine its upper end and lower end, its upper end is this one. It bears a projection which is called as a stylet process, and rest of the part of head is having a C-shaped impression for the articulation with the tibia to form the superior tibiofibular joint, and rest is having muscular attachment. Onto the inferior surface, this surface is more identified. You can see a triangular facet and a depression present posteriorly, or depression is present also present. This depression is called as malleolar fossa, and this is the triangular articular facet. Also, the downward projection here, this lower end is downward projecting. This is the lateral malleolus. The medial malleolus was present on tibia and the lateral malleolus is this one. So onto the lower end, a fossa is present, which is called as malleolar fossa, and a triangular articular facet. So to determine the side of fibula, we have to keep our thumb in this depression and hold it like a pen. So this bone is again of left side. Very clearly you can demarcate. First, the most important point is to determine the lower end. If you have determined that, then just keep your thumb in the malleolar fossa, and remember, the malleolar fossa lies posteriorly, and hold it like a pen. If I hold it in my right hand, then this is wrong, as the malleolar fossa is coming anteriorly, and also I can hold like this, keeping this facet and the malleolar fossa towards outside. No, this is also wrong because the thumb is not coming in this. So to hold it correctly, put your thumb in the malleolar fossa, keep it medially and hold it like a pen. So this bone is of left side. Right, if this was of right side, then malleolar fossa must be present here, so I can hold like this, but this is of left side. Now the last bone of lower limb, the carpals and the tarsals and metatarsals, we will study separately. This is patella, a triangular bone, a sesamoid bone, not a regular bone, it is a sesamoid bone, and is triangular in shape with the apex, base, anterior surface and posterior surface. Now anterior surface is this one and posterior surface is this one. On the posterior surface, a large articular facet is present because it articulates with the femur to form the knee joint. Patella articulates onto the femur. Now, how to determine its apex? Apex is triangular and base is flattened, as base is flattened like. On the posterior side, near to the apex, a rough area is present, and rest all the surface is covered by the articular facet. So this is the apex and this is the base, this is the posterior surface and this is the anterior surface. Now to determine its side, very simple thing to do, just keep the patella on the table. And the side on which patella is resting onto the table is the side of the bone belonging. Remember, the large side must come laterally. So that is the side determined. Large side is resting towards the lateral side, and that means this bone is of left leg only. If the bone was resting towards this side, then the large side comes to the lateral side. L for large, L for lateral side. So this bone will belong to the right side. But as the large surface is resting onto the lateral side on this side, so this is of left again. So that was all about the bones of lower limb. I hope it will be helpful for you in the examination, because these were the simplest step on the basis of which you can identify and determine the site and also the anatomical position of the bones. Hope you all are liking the videos. Please like and subscribe my channel,
And thank you so much for watching the video. Thank you.